Interventional oncology's gentle yet powerful therapies have revolutionized cancer treatment in the 21st century. At ECIO 2013, the discipline teamed with its natural ally radiation oncology to discuss professional issues in cancer care. Globally renowned figures in their respective fields, Dr. Liz Kenny, radiation oncologist, and Professor Andy Adam, interventional radiologist, give an exclusive interview on improving care standards.
Look, I think there's a major opportunity here for very close working collaboration between interventional oncologists and radiation oncologists. They're both very reliant on imaging. The focus is always on minimizing the toxicity of treatment, always on minimizing the toxicity of very significant open access that surgery might require. And so for that reason, the effectiveness of the interventional oncology techniques, the effectiveness of radiotherapy, the relative cheapness of their treatments, and the relative low morbidity for the patients who are having treatment are all really critical factors. So I think this is a golden opportunity for a very close collaboration.
I think an additional area in which we can really look forward to collaboration between radiation oncology and interventional oncology is working together as clinicians. And I think there are great benefits for patients there, working together in multidisciplinary meetings and bringing the knowledge of both interventional oncology and radiation oncology to common fora in the areas where we can discuss the most appropriate treatment. I think is very important, and I think working together in outpatient clinics and perhaps on ward rounds and being able to discuss patients together is another potential gain in this area.
There is an enormous research background demonstrating the benefit of radiotherapy, so they're expert clinicians. And they're expert researchers. Having access to expertise regarding study design, regarding the gaining of evidence, because in rapidly evolving technologies, the phase three randomized controlled trials are not going to be of any real value. The world is changing. And the push also for minimally invasive techniques that are going to be cheaper, that are going to be less morbid. All of that has such synergy between radiation oncology and interventional oncology.
The potential for working together in the sphere of education is enormous when it comes to radiation oncology and interventional oncology.
They have great potential within their fellowship to look at education programs, joint training programs, particularly for interventional oncologists who want to learn a lot more about cancer, other options for treatment, and also partnerships from an education point of view in communication skills and multidisciplinary team management. And so the possibilities are endless.
I think what the ECIO does well is educating those that attend the meeting in new techniques and the potential of the techniques that we employ as interventional radiologists to treat patients with cancer. So the focus on technology is clear, and keeping up with developments is something that this meeting does very well indeed.
So ECIO is now reaching out to other disciplines. There are a number of multidisciplinary sessions at this meeting that are involving surgeons and radiation oncologists and medical oncologists, and that's to be applauded. People need to know, the rest of the oncology community need to know about interventional oncology.